The Mahabharat is one of the greatest epics ever. It tells the tale of the good, the bad, and the ugly, and reminds the future generations of the results of hatred, greed, pride, and adharma. When the Kurukshetra war between the Pandavas and Kauravas ended, there were remains of destruction everywhere. Pandavas, despite winning the war, were unhappy. The blindfolded Gandhari was shedding tears for her 99 dead sons. One day, the Pandavas, accompanied by Krishna, arrived into the chambers of Gandhari to offer their apologies and condolences. She was devastated by the death of her sons, and in her rage, ignoring the Pandavas, she came to Lord Krishna and poured her anger onto him. Gandhari fumed and she said, "Shouldn't you have averted this war with your divine will and power? Is this what you do to your own creation? I requested you each and every day in the past troubled times to avert this disaster. Is this how you answer my prayers? Ask your mother Devaki, the pain of losing a child. She had 7 of her children being killed at birth, and now I have seen 100 sons of mine being butchered to death. If my ears of Shiva Bhakti have been true, and if I have been true to my husband, then O Krishna, may you die in 36 years from today. May Dwarka be flooded and every one of your Yadava kin perish by killing each other, just as you made the kins of Kuru kill one another." Soon after the outburst, Gandhari realized that she had been carried away and fell on Krishna's knees and started to cry. Krishna lifted her up and smiled and said that her curse will take effect, not just due to her devotion, but also due to the ever-changing sands of time. After 36 years, slowly, the curse of Gandhari started taking form. To know more about this story, watch our video linked in the comments below. Years later, mistaking the resting Krishna for a deer, a hunter named Jara shoots a poisonous arrow that pierces Lord Krishna's feet and injures him. After this event, Lord Krishna leaves the mortal world. Realizing his mistake, Jara performed the last rite of Lord Krishna as per Hindu traditions. When cremated, Lord Krishna's whole body turned into ashes except for his heart. Jara was shocked that the heart remained untouched by the fire. Unlike a biological heart, there was an exotic metallic encased device pulsating and radiating vibrant waves and currents. The hunter Jara was stunned and clueless. It is believed that a cosmic voice instructed him to tie the heart to a wooden log and toss it into the river. The heart floated through the river, and after a long period of time, it reached the shores of Puri in Orissa. Biswabasu, the head of the tribal community called Sabras, discovered the heart of Sri Krishna, which was in the form of a concentrated blue stone. The tribal head realized its divine nature, so he established the heart inside a cave and started worshipping it as Nila Madhav. Puri was then ruled by a king named Indradyumna, who was a Vishnu devotee. One night, Lord Vishnu came in his dreams and asked him to build a temple for him. Indradyumna then began to search for the finest image of the god and was made aware of Nila Madhav. The king deputed one of his counselors, Vidyapati, to travel to confirm its presence. There, he found that Nila Madhav was not available to anybody other than the head of the tribals, who was named Biswabasu. Vidyapati then married the chief's daughter, and this gave him the power to uncover Nila Madhav. Meanwhile, the king Indradyumna had another dream where Lord Vishnu advised him that a wooden plank of neem plant is floating across the ocean of Puri, and he should make the idols through that particular wood and install Nila Madhav inside the idol. After waking up from the dream, the king ran towards the rivers, where he actually found the neem wooden plank. Biswabasu helped the king lift up the wooden plank and handed over Nilamadhav to the king. Now, the sacred log called Brahmadaru had to be carved to make the god's idol, but there was a problem. No sculptor could even make a mark on it with their chisel. Vishwakarma, the architect of the gods, appeared before the king in the disguise of an old man. He said that he would do the job, but only on one condition. He said he was going to take 21 days to carve the image inside a sealed chamber, and nobody would disturb him till he was done with his job. The king agreed to the sculptor's condition and allowed him to work on the making of the idol inside a closed chamber. People could hear the sound of hammering and chiseling, but after a few days, there was no noise. The queen couldn't hear any sound from the chamber and became anxious and informed the king. She requested the king to open the chamber and see if the old man was alive. Indradyumna was reluctant, but upon the insistence of the queen, finally opened the doors to find the lord of architecture, Vishwakarma, making the idols. But as the king broke his promise, Vishwakarma disappeared immediately, leaving the half-built idols behind. This is the legendary explanation of the unusual icons that we see in the Garbhagriha of the temple. The king took it as God's will and installed the idols of Krishna, Subhadra and Balaram in the Jagannath temple of Puri. The Jagannath temple is one of the Char Dham, the four historical pilgrimage sites populated by the Hindus. It is also one of the most mysterious temples in the whole world. One of the many mysteries of Jagannath temple is the Naba Kalebara festival. Naba means new and Kalebara means body. Naba Kalebara is an ancient ritual associated with Lord Jagannath, which occurs at intervals of 12 to 19 years depending on the Hindu lunar calendar. During this ritual, the Brahma Padartha or Krishna's heart is replaced into a new idol. As a rule, only neem trees are used to carve out the idols of Lord Jagannath. No ordinary neem tree can be used for this purpose. Lord Jagannath is dark in color, so the neem tree from which his deities are to be carved should be dark. The neem tree of Lord Jagannath must have four principal branches, symbolizing four arms of Narayan. There must be a water body near the tree, like a river or a large pond and a cremation ground nearby. An anthill should be close to the tree, and at the roots of the tree there must be a snake pit of a cobra. No bird must have made nests in the tree, and no branches would have to be broken or cut. The tree has to be located near a three-way or should be surrounded by three mountains. No creepers or mold must have grown on the tree, and there have to be Varuna, Sahada and Vilva trees close by. There has to be a hermitage and a temple of Lord Shiva in the vicinity, and the most amazing requirement is that on the trunk of the tree there must be natural impressions of conch shell and chakra. On the day of Naba Kalebara, in the dead of night, four priests called Daitapatis walk towards the temple. Electricity would be shut down in the entire city of Puri, and security is arranged by the government of Orissa. The priests are blindfolded and their hands are wrapped with thick cloth as they enter the inner sanctum of their destination. There, the Daitapatis, in the middle of the night, work on transferring the Brahma Padartha or Krishna's heart from the old idol to the new one. The Naba Kalebara event also symbolizes that a soul or Brahman can never die. It only transfers from one body to another. After the Brahma Padartha is shifted to a new idol, no one knows what happens to the old idols, as they vanish or are they buried. It is not verified. When asked about their experience at this time, the Daitapatis said that they felt as though a rabbit is wiggling or jumping in and out from their hands. Apart from this experience, they haven't had any other paranormal experiences. About 50 years ago, one of the priests is said to have actually looked at the Brahma Padartha, and he reported that it was leaking a silvery liquid, which is why the statues get damaged and have to be replaced at regular intervals. He also claimed that the Brahma Padartha began rotating like a chakra when it was exposed to light and vibrated loudly. It was after this incident that a new rule was created that the Daitapatis have to be blindfolded and the heart would be transferred only during the middle of the night. It is noteworthy that almost all idols in Hindu temples are made of metals or stones, but the Jagannath idol is made of wood because it is said that the Brahma Padartha can electrocute you. The priests are asked to wear gloves during the transferring process. Metals and stones are good conductors of electricity, while wood is a poor conductor of electricity. Hence, wood is used to make these idols. It is also believed that the heart could be activated when exposed to light, since it vibrates all the time, which is probably the reason why the electricity switched off in the entire city when the Brahma Padartha is being shifted to a new idol. The priests, who are said to perform the ritual of transferring the heart, are said to die within a year of the ritual and are believed to attain moksha. The last Nabakalebara of Lord Jagannath was held in 2015, after a gap of 19 years, and the next Nabakalebara will be held in 2034.